And today I'm in my kitchen. So yeah, I'm like basically Rachel Ray. Like same. That's nice, no one cares.
Is this good enough? Oh frick, I don't have my viewfinder. Oh my god. Is it in focus? I don't think so. So today's video is going to be a really fun video. I'm in my kitchen, as you can tell, which means I'm actually on a cooking show. So today's video is going to be fall breakfast ideas, and I decided I wanted to film a collab with another one of my good YouTube friends. You guys probably know him because I've collabed with him before. His name is JT.
Jameer from My Life as Jameer, and I'll be showing you guys how to make amazing pumpkin spice overnight oats and energy bites. So if you guys want to see how to make it, then click right here and it will take you to my video. I hope you guys have a happy Halloween and be safe.
I will link his channel and his video down below. In this video, I'm showing you guys how to make super easy pumpkin spice waffles with pumpkin spice latte drizzle. Literally, it's the best thing in the world. They're actually cake waffles because it's a cake mix. The next thing is an easy 5-minute on-the-go French toast in a mug. That's something you could definitely make before school or whatever. And the waffles, and then this next thing is something you should probably make on the weekend. So this next thing is a really delicious croissant puff. So it's like with raspberries and it's just really good. And I'll show you guys how to make that as well. If you guys want to see how to make all these really delicious and yummy breakfast ideas for the fall time, then keep watching.
For the croissant puff, you're going to need eggs, milk, vanilla extract, large croissants, sugar, 8 ounces of cream cheese, and fresh raspberries. Starting in a large bowl, you're going to add all of your cream cheese, 2 eggs, 1 teaspoon vanilla, 2/3 cup of sugar. And just go ahead and beat that together to kind of cream the cream cheese. Sounds really weird. Then you're just going to go ahead and slowly, gradually add in 1 cup of milk between mixes. You want to add this in to where it gets really creamy and has a good consistency. Then in a 9-inch tin pan, you're going to add in your croissants. So I just used 3 of them. Mine came in a pack of 4, and then I just tore them up and added them all in there. Then I just added all of my fresh raspberries. You don't have to add as much as I did, but it's so good with a bunch of raspberries. And you're just gonna sprinkle those on top. Baby, I'm perfect, so let's start right now. I just added in my mixture, and the cream cheese did settle at the top and it looks kind of gross, but I promise it is delicious. You're gonna let that set for 20 minutes, and then once that is done setting, you're going to bake it at 350 degrees for 40 minutes.
Okay, and also I just wanted to mention that you need to make sure you need to keep an eye on it, because 10 minutes before it's done, you're gonna take it out and cover it with tin foil, because since the croissants are already baked and everything else isn't, that will brown a lot faster. So you just need to cover it with tin foil so it doesn't brown that fast and get burned. So make sure you keep an eye on it and not just wait for the timer to go off. Or you can set it to 30 minutes, and then that way you can do it and then set it again for 10 minutes if that's easier for you, but yeah.
Then once that is finished, just go ahead and cut it up and serve it. Baby, I'm perfect for you, and if you like, then I drive it with the windows down. And if you like, oh, and places we can. Seriously, this stuff is so good. I really suggest trying it. For the French toast in a mug, you're going to need a mug, cinnamon, pancake syrup, milk, a croissant, salt, and chocolate chips. So I'm just going to say the measurements instead of listing them, so because it's super easy. So just take 1/4 cup of milk, add that into your mug, and then add 1 egg and 2 tablespoons of syrup. I kind of went overboard there, oops. So just did a little bit more. And then you're going to need 1 teaspoon of cinnamon and a couple shakes of salt. Then just go ahead and mix that all together until it's all evenly combined. Then take a croissant or bread and tear it up and put it in your mug. Make sure that it's kind of submerged in the liquid because you want it to be French toast, you know what I'm saying? And then I also added chocolate chips. Again, this is optional. You don't have to, but it's so good with a lot of chocolate. I'm gonna microwave this for 2 minutes, but you need to make sure you stop it every 30 seconds and count to 10 and then put it back in, because you really want to make sure that it doesn't overflow at the top, because it just, you know, inflates in the microwave. So please make sure you do that. And seriously, guys, it's so easy, so fast, and so delicious. I'm in love with it. I'm gonna win this time. I roll and I roll till I change my luck. Yeah, I roll and I roll till I change my luck. Then this last thing is pumpkin spice waffles. So you're going to need 1 cup of water, 1 egg, 1/3 cup butter, and a pumpkin spice bread kit. Mine came with this latte glaze thingy, but if yours didn't, I will link a pumpkin spice glaze below to top it if you want to do that. So then you're going to need a waffle maker, obviously. And yeah, so you're just going to go ahead and start off by mixing together all of your ingredients. And just go ahead and add them in all at once. It doesn't really matter. And then stir that together. Also, I added a little bit more water because it did not turn out that liquidy. Now for the glaze, just go ahead and add in 2 tablespoons of milk and your packet if it came with it. And I'm stirring that together and just setting that aside. Then just go ahead and make your waffles, and depending on your waffle maker, you either need to spray it or not spray it with butter, but I don't have to spray mine, so yeah. And then just go ahead and top it with your drizzle and your whipped cream. So that is it for this whole video. I really hope you guys enjoyed. If you try any of these breakfast ideas, please tweet them and Instagram them to me and JT with the hashtag FallBreakfastWithMandJT. And I really hope you guys enjoyed. I will see you in my next video, and happy Halloween!